what we really like about the San Pedro and ayahuasca is that there's almost the sense of the guidance of the plant spirit.
Oh yeah.
And me and you can both pick up on it.
Welcome back to another episode on the Aaron Doughty Podcast. Today I have my best friend, Victor Oddo, who is, yay! He's here to, we're gonna be talking about a whole bunch of different stuff today. And yeah, just really sharing with you also what happened yesterday, because yesterday Victor came over, and many of you know Victor. Victor's my best friend. He's a YouTuber. He's a coach. Runs retreat. He does a whole bunch of different stuff. But him and I also, you know, we have a full-time purpose, which is like a company that we have together where we teach people to go full-time doing what they love. And yeah, we both got houses in Sedona. We live here now. But thank you for coming on the podcast.
You're welcome. It's an honor.
Awesome. So yeah, let's share a little bit about, you know, first off, how you doing?
I'm doing good, man. I've been staying with Aaron these past couple days. He's been nice enough to have me as a guest. And me and Aaron would, remember, we used to take these trips probably 3 or 4 times a year where I'd leave the family. Me and you would go off on a vacation. Yep. And it was very nice. And now that we both live in Sedona, we haven't been doing that. We just go home to each other's houses. So it's been kind of cool recapturing that sort of situation, which has been very good for me as a father and someone who's very involved with the family to kind of break away and just sort of
That's kind of an insight for you recently, right? Like
realizing,
because I think back in the day, I remember especially when we first started hanging out like 3 or 4 years ago, we would, you know, when you'd be away from the kids, you'd be feeling really guilty, like I should be there and I need to be around all the time, you know? And it was like a constant, I think, battle for you to really become okay with not being around 24/7.
Yeah. And, you know, I see that theme in a lot of people, like wanting something for themselves and then a guilt associated with it, as illogical as it may be, as in my case. As Aaron knows, I spend a ridiculous amount of time with my family. I put an insane amount of emphasis about being a good father. You know, me and Aaron do plant medicine. A lot of the times my intention is, how do I become a better father?
Yeah.
And yet, in spite of that, I work from home.
Yep.
You know, I play, go to the park every day with the kids. But in spite of that, when I would come just to do something for myself, whether it be pursue my own passions with like YouTube or something, or come to visit Aaron as another example, there would be this extreme level of guilt. Very like illogical and out of place, but it's a very powerful feeling, guilt, fear, these emotions. So they would successfully prevent me from enjoying myself and allowing myself to fly in a sense, whether it be hanging out with you or pursuing my passions or whatever it is. So it's been a big theme, as Aaron always points out.
I think the way that I grew up and, you know, my dad's a firefighter, so he's gone 24 hours a day, back 24 hours a day, like on and off for like 8 or 9 days. So I'm used to that. And then when I see you and it's like you're working from home, you're around the kid, like they're literally, now they're homeschooled. So they're around, like you guys are literally all around each other all day, every day. And then we'll go, you know, come over here, we'll go hiking or something like that. And it's like, oh, I wonder, you know, I got to get back. You know what I mean? Got to get back to the kids. But you've been better about that, about really creating a little bit more space. And I think, I'm sure they maybe appreciate it more now too. You know, like when you are around.
Yeah. I realized through experience and also just, you know, attracting other like sources of information into my life. Like me and Aaron, we had the Elliot Hall session.
Yep.
And he's a father and he kind of shared a perspective. So I've been attracting things into my life that have been making me question this guilt and making me realize too much of a good thing can be a bad thing. There's a word for it. I'm trying to think from the Karate Kid, but too much of a good thing can be a bad thing. And that's been the case with my kids. When I'm with them all the time, we drive each other nuts. And our time together is not of quality. When I'm like, I'm going to go back to the house in a little bit here after the podcast, but I'll go back and there'll be an appreciation and there'll be just a better vibe in a sense, because I took time for myself, which is okay.
Yeah. Interesting how that works. But that's cool, though. It's cool to see you go through that kind of, you know, transformation yourself. You know, we used to do these trips often. We're also both busier now, too.
True. Yes.
You know, like just with everything we have going on.
Yeah.
You know,
us lining up at the same time is more rare.
It's a little bit more rare, even though we now both live in Sedona or have a house here, at least, you know.
Yeah.
So, we're excited about that. You know, we have our Costa Rica retreat is in a week from Saturday. Like under 2 weeks. Crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. Dude,
anytime we have like an event or something going on, we're going to Costa Rica for like 4 or 5 days.
Like 10 days, like 9 days.
We're going to be there for 10 days, but yeah. The retreat itself will be like 5 days, right?
Yes.
And it's a plant medicine retreat, so it's ayahuasca. It's, mm-hmm. Our like really high level quality shaman that we bring in and stuff. And
yeah,
we're super excited about it. We did this back in November.
Yep.
And it was magical. And now we're doing it again. And then we'll plant the seed here now as well. There may be a woman's retreat, a woman's ayahuasca, like Costa Rica retreat. Victor and I will not be there. Mm-hmm. But if you guys are interested in that, maybe I'll just have a link or something.
Yeah, we'll leave a link. Right now, we're working out the details.
We're working out the dates and stuff.
It'll be the end of July.
Yeah, it'll be Victor's wife Patty running it, and it'll be only for women. Women's only.
Yeah, the shamans will be guys. There's one.
Yeah,
guy
there will
shaman.
Be there will be one woman shaman. There'll be a husband and wife shaman that are amazing, and then a guy Wachumero who does the Wachuma, and it's magical as well. But yeah, so but it will be like a woman's retreat. And yes. That'll be like end of July to August area. So we'll kind of plant the seeds with you guys now. And we'll have the exact dates soon. But maybe by the time this comes out, if you guys go to, go to aarondoughty.com/womensretreat. Women's retreat. aarondoughty.com/womensretreat. You'll see the new details there. And that will be launched, yeah, soon.
Cool.
So yeah, we're excited about that. Excited to travel for there. And yesterday, actually, Vic, you came here, and then mm-hmm. we decided, okay, let's do some Wachuma.
Yes.
Wachuma San Pedro, and it's a medicine of the heart, opens up the heart, and it's something, we're not saying everyone to go do it or anything. We're just sharing with you, we do this kind of stuff to like almost open up different levels of our consciousness and kind of go within ourselves to become aware of patterns. And it was a very powerful experience that we had yesterday. So I thought maybe we'd share a little bit about like what we experienced, what was coming up for us. And right from the get-go, when we were getting ready to do it, first off, we got up in the morning. We're getting ready to do this challenge thing, this 3-day Start Your Spiritual Business challenge thing. So we get up and we're like, okay, we're going to get like an hour of work done. And the reason when you're taking Wachuma or San Pedro is it lasts like 12 hours. So you normally take it earlier in the day. It's normally a social thing. So you're around other people. It's not like Aya where you're like in a different dimension and stuff. It's like you're here, it's normally done in social group, as well, type activity dynamics. And before we did it at like 8 a.m, we got up to like get some work done and to film some like Facebook ads because we were launching this 3-day free full-time purpose challenge. We're showing people how to go full-time doing what they love. And we're like really excited about it. But when we were getting ready to make these ads, we were feeling a lot of resistance mm-hmm. because we were trying to do it we were trying to cram a whole bunch of work into a short amount of time. We were trying to do it in a way that wasn't necessarily in alignment.
Yes.
Right. So it was, we did a little bit of work and then afterwards we put it to the side and then going into it, we're like, okay, getting ready to take it. That's not the most pleasant thing to drink. You know what I mean? It's like a powder that gets into water. You just mix it up, you drink it. And we're getting ready to do that. And it was you were like, okay, what did you say to me?
Yeah, Aaron was like, what did you ask me? You were like, well, what's your intention? And then I said, oh, I'm feeling kind of nervous.
Yeah.
Because
you're being honest.
And I find this to be the case with people who come to my retreats. I find it to be the case oftentimes when I'm going to go to a retreat or drink medicine, that it's almost like my higher self will start to kick stuff up in anticipation for this opportunity to release it. So my point is, prior to drinking it, I had a lot of fear and anxiety and just old emotions coming up to the point where I started feeling almost paranoid and I really didn't want to drink it.
Yeah,
I knew I've understood this.
I could feel
process.
That. I could feel that you didn't want to drink it.
Yeah, but I knew what was happening. I knew you're going to drink it, and the very things that are coming up that are making you feel kind of uneasy are the things that you'll get to work on and probably release in this time.
Yeah.
So I felt really apprehensive. But yep. Me and you, we gulped it down. We chased it with a little bit of honey and yep. went and sat down and started talking. And then it started to kind of come on. And from there, me and Aaron just sat there for a few hours just talking. It's cool because I'm the medicine. It's almost like what we really like about the San Pedro and ayahuasca is that there's almost the sense of the guidance of the plant spirit.
Oh yeah.
And me and you can both pick up on it. And there's a time where we can both sense that now it's Aaron's turn to share.
Yeah.
And then it's like, I just sit there and listen and ask questions, and Aaron will go there and he'll explore different ideas and make these connections. And then you can like almost sense it when, okay, it's your turn now, Vic. And Aaron will be like, oh, what are you dealing with, buddy? Yeah. So there's a bit of that for a few hours. It was very productive. I don't know if you wanted to go into like what we were working with.
But yeah, let's talk about it. It was
very powerful. Okay.
Let's talk about it.
All right.
Yeah. So what were you?
You started off. You're the one making connections first. You want to go first with what you were working with about?
What was it about?
It was about like boundaries and the last vestiges of the nice guy sort of coming out of you and how you're integrating this new version of yourself, but it's not quite set yet. There's still some lingering emotions and stuff.
Yeah, there's the thing that I've been working with a lot recently is the whole nice guy thing, letting go of seeking approval. And in a way, this last like 4 or 5 months for me has been like some of the most transformative times of my life, where I've been really become firm with who I am and my own masculinity. And a lot of that has meant what I realize is that when it comes to the nice guy, which is a shadow. The shadow is a nice guy is somebody that is pleasing other people and is trying to exchange validation, is trying to exchange like being nice for approval and validation. And the thing that I realized about myself was I've made this shift into this new identity, and my energy has completely changed. But there's certain reflections I get back in my life of how I used to be and certain people that expect to see me as I used to be, so it's kind of a shock for them. And there's almost like a boundary thing where I'm like keeping certain people at bay and creating boundaries where I almost don't want to, in a way, see them because I want to continue to establish my own frame. And I think the big insights that I have was I've been setting these boundaries. I go within my own body. Basically, a lot of it was the nice guy thing was becoming aware that before I would value approval and significance from other people. So I'd want to like say things that like almost enhance people's frame and at the expense of authenticity. But then what I realized is that I had to redefine my own sense of authenticity and realize that I value authenticity more than any level of being nice. Like I like to go into tension now, like as you know, like I'm you know, wanting to learn Muay Thai. You know, I have a Muay Thai trainer that we're going to be working with. Like I'm doing these things that are I feel naturally called to now. Like, you know, some people say, oh, like doing UFC stuff, you know what I mean? Like I think that'd be cool to learn. Not that I'm going to go compete or anything, but there's like a part of my personality, things I used to never see myself really drawn to, I'm now drawn to. And I think that that's like a new identity emerging. This is a clip from the Daily Vortex podcast where I post 2 times a week and we go really deep on understanding consciousness, understanding how to raise our vibration, how to bring these spiritual concepts down to earth in a relatable and practical way. For the whole entire episode, you can click the link below, but also subscribe to that of the Daily Vortex podcast on either iTunes or Spotify. That's where there are a backlog of over 100 episodes, plus the whole entire episode length is there. On this channel, you will only be seeing clips moving forward. So if you want the whole episodes, you can click the link below. You can subscribe. They're also very easy to listen to. They're automatically downloaded once you subscribe, plus you'll never miss an episode. So this is where most of my intention is and my energy is going these days. And I look forward to bringing you many more amazing episodes. But for the rest of this episode, you can click below and you can subscribe to the Daily Vortex podcast. And I look forward to helping you expand your consciousness in a very practical and relatable way. So I'll see you on the next episode. And as always, peace, much love, and namaste.